one of the great things about Interplay is the extent they go to help their employees. I remember, you know, one time a lot of the producers were having problems with Microsoft Project and learning it and understanding it. And Interplay, sparing no expense, went straight to Bill Gates to come in and help us learn this product.
This Microsoft Project, yeah. It's very helpful, it's very easy, and it's set up in tasks. There's three tasks. There's like first task, second task, third task. Mm-hmm. And I've assigned an employee to each task right. For this example.
Okay.
So like, who's on first task? What's on second task? I don't know is on third task.
That's what I want you to tell me is the guy's named on the task.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. Who's on first task? What's on second task? I don't know is on third task.
Do you know the fellow's names?
Yes.
Well, then who's on the first task?
Yes.
I mean the fellow's name on the first task.
Who?
The guy on the first task.
Who?
This guy here on the first task.
Who is on first task?
Well, what are you asking me for?
I'm not asking you. I'm telling you. Who is on first task?
I'm asking you who's on the first task.
That's the man's name?
That's whose name?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
Who?
The guy on the first task.
Who?
This first task guy.
Who is on first task?
Have you got a guy on this first task?
Certainly.
Then who's on the first task?
Absolutely.
When you pay off this guy who does the first task, when you pay him off, who gets the money?
Every dollar of it. Why shouldn't he? After all, the man earns it.
Who does?
Yes.
All I'm trying to find out is what's the guy's name on this first task?
What's the guy's name on the second task?
I'm not asking you who's on the second
task. Who's on first task?
That's what I'm trying to find out.
Well, don't change him around.
I'm not changing nobody. What's the guy's name on the first task?
What's the guy's name on second task?
I'm not asking you who's on the second
task.
Who's
on first task?
I don't know.
He's on third task and we're not there yet.
You know, actually, the more I think about it, the more I get pissed off that some people in this company think we are idiots because we don't understand this grossly overproduced product. I'm sorry.
Okay, I think I got it. Now, I want to be a good manager, and Microsoft Project will help me become a good manager.
Yes.
Okay, so let's say someone on this first task gets sick. Now, me being a good manager, I want to get things running smoothly, so I take this first task and give it to who?
Now, that's the first thing you've said right all night.
I don't even know what I'm talking about!
That's all you have to do.
Is to give away this first task.
Yes.
Now, who's got it?
Naturally.
Who has it?
Naturally.
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 Okay.
All right.
So I take this first task and I give it to Naturally.
No, you give it to who?
Naturally.
Yes.
Okay.
All right.
So I pick up this first task and I hand it over to Naturally.
No, you give it to who?
Naturally.
Yes. Now say it that way.
That's what I'm saying.
No, it isn't.
I said I give the task to Naturally.
No, you give it to who?
Naturally.
Yes.
That's what I'm saying.
You're not saying that.
All I want to know is what's the guy's name on the first task?
What's the guy's name on the second task?
I'm not asking you who's on the second
task. Who's on the first task?
I don't know.
Third task.
See? Simple.
You know, getting everyone's side of the story, that's the Interplay racket.
The future. Any dream of Interplay actually moving has melted. And the parking lot lies beneath a vehicle grave.
What did you see out there in the 15 Lunars?
Such as?
An end to all these cars?
You're asking the wrong person.
Parking reserve sign.
So what's it worth? We trading or not?
And the human dream is the search for a mythical place called a parking spot.
It doesn't exist!
How can you be sure?
Because I have driven around here more than most have dreamed. And I've never seen it.
This lot, this whole way of parking, it's ending.
Will the owner of license plate number 3CGU741 please move your vehicle?
Bingo!
A straight line leading directly to a parking space?
A parking space is not just our destination,
but it is our destiny! Yeah!
For the last time, will the owner of license plate number 3CGU741 please? Never mind.
Why did it have to be Matt?
He surpassed his elusive supervisor.
Help me!
Sign this first.
He delivered the source code to the proper authorities.
You're too late, Jones. I was here first. Snooze, you lose. Woo! Yeah! Na 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 na.
Sign it.
He survived the dreaded 2 o'clock check run.
Can you sign this, Chuck? Thanks!
He survived the massive ball of red tape. But will he survive?
Number 76?
The Gauntlet of Doom. Indiana Jones and the Project Check Request. This time, the odds are really against him.
They've embarrassed me for the last time. I want you to make an example out of this guy. I want everyone to know what will happen if they miss one more ship day.
Man, we should have super soakers for this kind of deal.
Why? How many guys you think they got up there?
5 or 6.
Shit, we should have super soakers for this. You know what they call Boogerman in Paris?
They don't call it Boogerman?
Nah, they're on the snot system over there. They don't know what the fuck a booger is.
What do they call it?
They call it Snot Royale.
Snot Royale. What do they call Stonekeep in Paris?
Late.
Hey, there's Fred Royale.
With jeans. We're associates, your friends in sales. You do remember your friends in sales, don't you?
Yes, I remember them.
And can you tell me why they're not your friends anymore?
Because we missed our ship date.
Check out the big brain on Ken. You're a smart motherfucker, Ken. That's right, because you missed your ship date. You read the producer Bible, Ken?
Yes.
Well, there's this passage I got memorized, sort of fits the occasion, from Pavlos 10:16. When he delegates something, he is expecting it to be taken care of. He completely forgets about it. And if you don't take care of it, it will be lost. And God forbid he should remember that he gave you that task and you didn't do anything with it.
Now, where's Finley's office?
Die, bastard, die!
McHugh in the conference room immediately. Can Dick Lehrberg please dial 0?
Marty!
Doc!
What are you doing? Stonekeep ships the memory? If it doesn't, Marketing will have our ass in a sling!
Well, hold on to your ass, Doc, because it ain't gonna make it.
Great business! Thank goodness I prepared a backup plan!
McHugh!
Ah, we stand!
Hey, McHugh, have you
you finished my Microsoft project report yet?
Gee, sorry, Weeze. We've been a little busy, all right?
Hello? Fuck you. Give up on Stokey. PC suck and you should have done it on a Mac.
Well, Weeze, if I had a time machine, I would have changed a lot of things.
Precisely what I had in mind, Marty.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, Doc. Are you trying to tell me you built a time machine? Out of a Dodge?
Who's it gonna use? Pavlish's car? That thing won't even go 88.
It's crazy, Doc.
No, Marty. It makes perfect sense. We'll just take the time machine to the future to when Stokey actually ships, buy it, and bring back the source code.
You're the Doc, Doc.
What is it, Lou?
Oh, my God. They found me. I don't know how, but they found me.
Run for it, Marty!
Who? Who?
Who do you think? Marketing!
Holy shit!
Get in, Marty! How much disk space it takes to install this thing? Ah, 1.21 gigabytes! Ah, 1.21 gigabytes!
The Q?
Ah, 1.21 gigabytes!
What the hell's a gigabyte?
How could I be so careless?
Grandpa Weeze! Grandpa! I don't like you no more!
Well, fuck you!
Fuck you!
No, fuck you!
Fuck you, Grandpa!
Wait a minute, Doc, let me see this. No wonder! There's 900 levels!
Well, just get rid of the first 800 and ship as is!
This should work. But wait, Doc, as long as we got a time machine, let's do some time traveling.
Marty, I didn't invent the time machine to travel through time. I invented it to make money!
Okay, but at least let's go see if Rusty ever went decaf.
Time machine? Stupid secretary.
Yes, Mr. Weeze?
Billy Gates. I'm feeling particularly sorry about buying your company and ruining your life, so here's a quarter. I hit the road. And, what do we say?
PC suck.
Very good. Be gone with you.
Mr. Weeze, there's a Doc Fargo and Marty McHugh here to see you.
Throw them out immediately.
Somehow, the space-time continuum has been disrupted!
Doc, English!
We screwed up time! Marty, it's all very simple. Look at this receipt! It's from the Stonekeep hint book that must have been purchased in the future. Look at the date! I found it in the time machine, where I also found this! Which proves that Weeze was in the time machine. He must have purchased the Stonekeep hint book somewhere here in 2025. And then transported himself back in time to some point back here, handed himself the Stokey hint book, which he built the Empire based on the information contained in that hint book, which is why we have this alternate interplay right here. Marty, listen to me very carefully. According to the time machine log, we took it back to November 6, 1975. Now you have two missions. One, steal the Stonekeep hint book back from the younger Weeze, and two, convince my younger self of the pitfalls of Stonekeep.
I'm telling you, Weeze, with this book, you'll be all-powerful. Are you tripping? Why do you keep calling me Weeze? My name is Bill. Just fucking read it. Man, I was a butt munch when I was a kid.
Weeze, look!
Why does everybody keep calling me Wheeze?
I am Thera, goddess of computer nerds. Prepare yourself, for your never-ending journey awaits. You must descend into the financial vacuum of Stonekeep to protect you from the terror of the marketing team. I will tell you now that Stratavision and filming outdoors just won't work. Achieve your goal, and 50,000 man-hours will be set free. Fail, and you shall be entombed by the dark forces of missed ship dates forever.
Stonekeep 2.
Quick, Benny!